tell me about advanced energy economy, what your organization does, and what advanced energy in this context means.
Well, the advanced energy economy is a new business organization we formed about 2 years ago, and we work to have an impact to promote a world that will run on secure, clean, affordable energy. We emphasize with our partners in many states and regions a business voice to have an impact on good public policy decisions, particularly at the state level.
Now you said impact. Tell me about the economic impact of advanced energy as you define it.
The advanced energy economy on a global basis is over a $1.1 trillion market opportunity based on 2011 data that we received from research with Navigant Research. In the United States, that is a multi-billion dollar, over $152 billion market, and it's growing rapidly. So we've identified this as a market opportunity that is larger than global pharmaceutical. It's larger than the trucking transportation industry. It is a very substantial opportunity for companies large and small to have economic growth, create jobs, pay taxes to state, local, and federal government. And that is what our organization works to do, to promote better public policy to encourage the growth of the companies across this spectrum of what we call advanced energy. So this is in addition to what some would call renewables. It's solar, of course, and wind, and biofuels, and electric vehicles. It's energy efficiency, it's smart grid. It's the opportunity to embrace innovation in the natural gas area, innovation in nuclear, but particularly we would call the growth sector of the low carbon industry.
You mentioned impact. Your members want you to have an impact. That's your on public policy. What are you hearing from them vis-a-vis what Washington can do, what local governments, something that you know something about, and city governments, what are they looking for mainly? What's the top line of what they're looking for, your members?
Most of our business owners, whether that's an entrepreneur that's just getting started with an innovative new hydroelectric power system that can be used in small rivers or streams or wastewater treatment facilities, or whether it's a large company like a Verizon that's involved in making sure that the communication system to build the smart grid is there. They're asking for certainty of public policy. They're asking to make sure that if there are tax incentives, if there are expenditures, if there are programs, that they be open and available to the advanced energy companies, not just the traditional oil companies or the big coal companies or very traditional energy. They're also saying we need to have a way of encouraging innovation. Uniquely in this country, we have been leading the world in technology innovation around the internet, in medical technology innovation. We want to see a leadership role in energy innovation and energy technology innovation. And we see this as a golden opportunity for Americans to generate business growth and jobs and export of product and services in 7 major categories, 41 subsectors. As I say, it's a massive economic opportunity. That's what we talk about at the federal level and the state level with a business voice, joining together to come forward with new ideas and new approaches for policy that will work to help us be more secure, more clean, and more affordable with our energy future.
You're here at the Bloomberg New Energy Finance Summit. What's your sense of the summit? What's your headline from, if you had to pick one headline, what would it be from your experience here for the last day or so?
I am sensing and feeling and talking to people who have a great deal of optimism about the opportunity. The global energy demand is looking like it will be close to a 40% demand increase between now and 2030. That says to the business leaders, the finance leaders, and the government leaders, that this is about an economic opportunity of unprecedented opportunity. Never in my lifetime have I seen a greater chance for us to build prosperity around innovation and the growth of advanced energy. This market is one of the largest markets in the country and the world, but we haven't identified it as such. We haven't looked at it in the advanced energy economy aggregate. And so that optimism that I see when I talk to people is this is an upside opportunity. There's been a lot of gloom and doom about what's happening in energy. I don't see that happening here. I see people coming up with new ideas, and particularly in new ideas around finance, new ideas of ways to bring capital in, whether that's debt capital or equity capital, to help grow these business opportunities. Community by community, state by state, an anecdote, I realize it's a data point, one of the fastest growing clubs at university colleges, campuses, and community colleges are energy clubs. Who joins an energy club? It's a young person who has a dream, who wants to start a company, who wants to become the chief sustainability officer of Verizon someday, or who wants to be able to say, I helped move my country for the benefit of the world and the benefit of a better prosperity over the next generations. And that's why we believe that this is a great opportunity, and I see that reinforced here in almost every conversation. Yes, there are challenges, yes, there are problems, but this is a place where Republicans and Democrats can come together. We had an excellent conversation with the senior ranking member of the Senate Energy Committee, and she was very clear about potential for compromise around energy. This is a place where Republicans and Democrats today at the local level and at the state level are coming together to make good policy decisions. That's an optimistic view, a positive view of what we can do.
Thank you very much for being here.
Good, thank you.